After having the EveryDollar app for 1 year, here's my honest review about it and whether I recommend you should use it. The EveryDollar app was created by a company called Ramsey Solutions, which is famously owned by Dave Ramsey. And the model that the app uses is the same model that Dave Ramsey uses when it comes to budgets, and that's called a zero-based budget, meaning you allocate all of your income to expenses and/or savings. The goal is that your income minus your expenses, minus your savings or investing, or paying off debt, equals $0. Dave Ramsey likes to say, give every dollar an assignment. Be very intentional about your budget. Any place that you're putting your paycheck goes into your budget so that we can see every single dime of where the income's going. Which can sound complicated, but one thing I actually like about every dollar is it's very simple. It's strictly a budget app. There's a lot of other budget apps out there that do a lot of other things besides budgeting, like helping you invest your money, managing your bank account, giving you a net worth calculator, which if you're looking for other tools, may be a negative, but if you want something that's just very simple, then every dollar is probably right for you. Every dollar also opens up straight to the front page of your budget, whereas other apps like Mint, you have to click on the app and then do one or two more clicks before you actually get to the front page of your budget. This makes every dollar simpler and quicker to use, and there's no advertisements. This is probably my favorite thing about every dollar. I don't want to open up my budgeting app and see advertisements for credit cards while I'm trying to sift through that to get to my budget. Every dollar, it opens right up and there's no advertisements constantly bombarding me as I'm trying to plug in my expenses. Every dollar is free. You can go to your app store and you can download every dollar. There's a free version and there's a paid for version. The free version, which is what I use, is good, but it does take a decent amount of work to plug in all your expenses. Usually what I do is open up the EveryDollar app and then open up my banking app, and whatever I've been spending money on, I will put those expenses into the EveryDollar app. You have to do it manually by typing out the date, how much you spent, and what category you want that to go through. So if I spend 30 bucks at the grocery store, I had to open up the EveryDollar, put 30 bucks, April whatever, 2021, and put that in the grocery category of my budget. The paid version cuts this time down because you can sync your bank account with the EveryDollar app, and whenever you do make a transaction, it'll pop up on your EveryDollar app and you just slide it into whatever category. But it's obviously a service that you'd have to pay for at that point, and the price right now is $129 for 12 months, which to me is a little expensive, a little over $10 a month so that you can budget, and a lot of times you're budgeting to try to save money, so that could be a negative there. So I like apps on my phone to be very user-friendly. I don't want there to be a whole lot of confusion. What I like about EveryDollar is it's very clear if you're sticking to your budget or not. It has a big number on the front of the page and has three tabs that'll tell you how much you plan on making in income this month, how much you spent on expenses and savings and investings, and the third tab is how much money you have remaining. And if you go over budget on any line item, you scroll down and you see that it's in red. So if you went over $10 on the grocery budget, it'll be minus $10 in red. So it's very easy to see, okay, I'm spending more on groceries. Maybe next month I have to bump that up $10 and I have to take $10 out of another category so I can put that money towards groceries. For me, it's a very, very easy budget to balance. So if you like to see detail and you like to see the numbers come together and everything to be clean, it's good because it's that zero-based budget and it's very user-friendly. Now, one thing about the EveryDollar, which may seem like a negative, is there's a ton of different line items and categories, which could be overwhelming and just take a ton of time to plan out every single line item. But what you can actually do is you can delete whatever line items you want, and you can also put in custom line items. So if you want to have a miscellaneous category, if you want to have an Amazon fund category, whatever you want to put, you can manually put in there. So it actually could be a positive because it is very easy to edit. I know a lot of people like to run budgets where you get, hey, $100 a week to spend on fun stuff or $200 a month to spend on fun stuff. Well, it'd be very easy to just put a category in there that's customized to say fun, $200 for the month. So all in all, I would highly recommend it. I've tried probably every budgeting app out there, and this is the one that I've stuck with the longest because I think it's the most straightforward, the biggest thing being no advertisements, it's all right there in front of me. But a budget is only gonna work as hard as you do at the budget. If you wanna be intentional and you wanna have control over your money and you wanna get out of debt or start investing, then this would be a great place to start. You can download it and use the free version today. Now, if you've never actually budgeted before, keep this in mind. It may take at least 3 months before you actually have a good idea of how much money you spend on certain things. So the most amount of work is gonna be front loaded when you start the budget, just trying to figure out how much you actually make and how much you actually spend. But once you actually figure that out, it's pretty easy because with the EveryDollar app, it transfers over month to month. So if you plan to spend $150 in gas and your mortgage is $1,500, you don't have to go back and replug that in every month. It'll carry over to the next month with that pre-built template. The biggest thing is gonna be to stick with it, to not wash out. The more control that you have over your money, the more things your money will be able to do for you. Thanks for watching, guys. Go ahead and subscribe if you have not already. We just passed over 500 subscribers, which is awesome. Thank you all for subscribing and thanks for watching this video. There's new videos every Monday. I try to post them around noon. If you got anything at all out of this video, you like the content, please hit the like button. It helps out a lot. I'll see you guys next week.